Hey everybody, I hope you're having a great day so far. Today we're going to talk about the lack of respect towards healthcare workers. First, please excuse my appearance, including these 16-hour shift bags under my eyes. I definitely should be heading to sleep right now instead of recording this video, but I really think it's important for one, me to get it off my chest so that I can go to sleep without taking some of this toxicity with me, and two, because I think some people really need a reminder on what it means to be respectful, as sad as that might be. As you can tell, I had less than a wonderful encounter last night, but I'm not gonna get into that because I don't wanna get my blood boiling again. Because, you know, it's just not worth it. Instead, I want to put out a sort of a PSA on respect and talk about strategies with handling unfortunate situations when there's the lack of respect. I think that it's pretty clear that nursing and healthcare in general have become more of a service industry rather than health and medical ones. With all the emphasis on surveys and age caps, you would think that the H out front stands for hotel and not hospital. And with that said, I hold waiters and hospitality staff to such a high regard because people can be really mean and demanding and nasty and just plain disrespectful. And despite all that verbal abuse, you just have to kind of stand there and eat it and try to prevent your eyes from rolling out of your head or getting defensive. Here are some strategies to use when patients or families put you in this unfortunate situation. Number one, stop, collect yourself. Don't bark back no matter how hard they come at you. It'll only multiply their reactions. Two, keep it short. When responding, be objective and concise. Allow them to know that they're being heard, but less is more in this situation. If you're trying to figure out the issue, try a technique called mirroring, which gets the person to volunteer information simply by asking questions using the last couple words from their own response. For example, if a person says, "I'm really not happy with anything about this day," you respond, "Anything about this day?" And then they elaborate. They can go on about people aren't answering the call bells fast enough or this and that. And you basically just continue this with all of their future responses. To be honest, it's as if this person is having a conversation with themselves, but you learn a little bit in the process. Number three, offer solutions. However, frame it in a way that it seems as though they're coming up with the ideas. Ask for their input. How can we make this better? Number four, don't be afraid to ask for backup. Sometimes there's just no reasoning with some people. There are many Looney Tunes out there, and I'm sure you'll encounter some of them. Be sure to use your managers or charge nurses for help when dealing with unruly patients and visitors as well. And for patients, this is my message to you, and please accept this message on behalf of what I'd imagine is most nurses. Please understand that we're trying. We're caring for a lot of loved ones on the unit, and although we'd like to give undivided attention to every single patient, that's just not possible. We don't really like to hear, "Are you understaffed or something?" And if we are, we're making every effort to appear as though we're not, sacrificing bathroom breaks and meals many times. We understand that you want to talk to the doctor, but sometimes the doctor isn't available. Many times, we can answer your questions. We only ask that if there's a bunch of family members involved, that you communicate with one another, because chances are, your question has already been answered when your brother asked it before. And that's not to say that we don't want to reinforce something that you don't quite understand, but it can kind of get a little tedious if we're answering the same things over and over again, and people just aren't communicating. And lastly, please just don't forget that we're people too. And as people, we deserve respect, as we intend to give you as well. If after watching this video, you're still going to continue to treat people in service industries, including nurses, like crap, I just wanted to tell you that it does not make you look cool. It does not make you more important. And it does not make people more willing to help you. Instead, you just tick off the people whose help you need, and you reveal how embarrassing and small you really are. Thanks for listening to my little vent session. I hope you're able to take away at least something useful on either side. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments below or on social media. If you enjoyed this video, please consider hitting the like button or subscribing to my channel. Until next time, everybody, take care, be good. And I'm gonna go get some sleep now.